Well, I was just, we were talking about that before the show started, that these things have now become Reagan days. I remember during the 08 campaign, there was a Reagan talk where all the presidential candidates, all the Republican candidates, gave a talk at the Reagan Library.
Right.
As if kind of promoting this idea that Reagan has become almost a larger-than-life figure on the Republican side, kind of like FDR or JFK is on the Democratic side. Why do you think he's taken on that aura? Is it that he espoused individual responsibility better than any others, or?
I think he was he was called the great communicator, and he did communicate those principles. And by and large, he tried to pass those principles into legislation when he was president. And I got to tell you, when he passed away, the roads, you remember, were lined with people all the way up to the library where they had the funeral. And to me, it was just, I got to tell you, I mean, the guy had, we hadn't heard about him or from him for 10 years. Mm-hmm. But when he passed away, I mean, I got to tell you, it was very moving to me. Yeah. And I think that shows you the kind of impact that he had on people's lives.
Okay. Well, I think that's fair. I often joke with my students that before my lifetime is over, probably before theirs, Reagan will end up on money. He'll end up on a dime or a quarter or something, because we tend to.
Well, it is a little ironic that that he has an airport named after him when he was, you know. But I do enjoy flying into the Ronald Reagan National Airport.
Well, before we move into some local stuff, just a kind of a final ideology kinds of question: how, as a Republican, would you define Democrats and their beliefs? How would you characterize them?
Well. You know, I got to tell you, I was at this governor's forum the other night that Senator Frist's organization SCORE had. It was in Nashville, and we had all seven. This is the first time I'd ever seen all seven nominees for governor in one place at one time. Might have been the first place. I can't remember, but it's the first time I'd ever seen all three Democrats speak in one place. And one thing that struck me about that, not only did we have superior candidates, by the way, but they. The three nominees espoused the old Democrat values of you can't get ahead without government. All three of them. And to me, that really spelled out what the Democrat Party's all about. And, you know, if you believe that, I respect it. You know, I'm very respectful of, Chip Forrester, who's the Democrat chairman. We have a very cordial relationship, and I respect his viewpoints on things. I just totally disagree with it. But that's what I would simply put it, that to get ahead, you have to have a reliance on government.
All right. Well, that actually segues well into the governor's race. Obviously, this fall's governor's race is drawing a lot of attention, and millions of dollars have already been raised, and of course, this is your part of your job here. How important is money in today's political races?
It's important. It's always been important. Mm-hmm. You know, if somebody tells you that money is not important, or it's never been important, it is. I mean, you know, back in Abraham Lincoln's day, I'm sure it took some money to get on the train and to print some flyers or, you know, do whatever they did. But it's important. I mean, is it the end-all thing? No, but you do have to have funds to get your message out. And if you have the money to get your message out, that's what you need. And each campaign has to decide for their own campaign plan how much money that is. Mm-hmm. Now, the Republicans there's a difference of about $9 million between the Republican candidates and how much they've raised and how much the Democrats have raised.
Okay.
And I would say that is a pretty considerable difference. And early on in the campaign, that's really the only way that you can judge about what kind of support a person has, how they're doing in their campaign, and that kind of thing. It's not the only yardstick, but it's a yardstick. And as a group, the Republicans are doing much better than the Democrats. And so I can say that I think right now that kind of shows you where we are. And I bet if we polled right now, we would be winning.
Well, that's the old wag, isn't it, that the candidate that's able to raise the most money, commands the biggest war chest, is the one who will win the
Not
election.
Always. It's a good barometer, mm-hmm. but it doesn't mean necessarily that you win. But, you know, each campaign has to decide how much money they need, and then how much money they need to, you know, how much money they need to run their race.
Okay. Well, speaking of specific races, what about the 6th District? This is one of those congressional races that's getting a lot of attention. Bart Gordon is retiring.
It's good subject matter. I like that.
Yeah.
6th District.
The 6th District. Can you make any predictions about how the primary...
Republicans are going to win. Because, well, let me tell you, unless the other side finds a candidate, which, you know, the old philosophy is that no opponent is the best opponent. And the Democrats have not found an opponent yet.
Yeah.
So as of the taping of today,
right.
They have not found an opponent. So we have some really good candidates. You know, one's right here in Sumner County. We have, if you want me to go through them, I can. There's Kerry Roberts, who's a bike store owner and he's from Robertson County. We have State Senator Diane Black, who is from Sumner County. We have State Senator Jim Tracy, who represents Bedford and Rutherford. The Rutherford County Chairman, Luann Zelnick, is a candidate. Gary Mann and Dave Evans mm-hmm. are our candidates. And mm-hmm. so we have a really good field of people.
Good.
The Democrats don't have anybody.
Well, last question then, as far as the campaigning and whatnot goes, and this is something you should have some definite insight to, being an old broadcast
a political
person.
Hack.
I didn't say that. Broadcast journalism.
Yeah.
Do you believe there is media bias? And if so,
I do.
All right. What are some examples?
Yeah, I mean, I was in not for a long time, but I had a taste of it. I worked as a reporter in Oklahoma, mm-hmm. covering the legislature. And then I went to Washington and worked for NBC Radio News as an editor. And, you know, I don't think it's anything intentional. I just think it's just there. I think that the majority of people that are reporters happen to be liberal. Mm-hmm. And again, I don't really like to tag people like that, but,
sure.
you know, for sake of time, I do. And again, I don't think there's any kind of conspiracy. I don't think it's anything intentional. But I do think that there is a liberal slant to the news.
Do you think that's true across the board? And then I've heard some commentators say that television and print media tend to be more liberal, but radio and now blogs tend to be
conservative. That's a new phenomenon,
sure.
the blogs. And, it depends on who's putting together the blog and all that. I mean, just in general, broadcast news, radio and TV, and newspaper, I believe, is slanted to the left.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's no doubt. But I mean, you know, there's a lot of people, reporters, that I've known for a long time that are my friends. We don't necessarily agree on everything. I don't think there's a conspiracy. I don't think that the editors and all the major newspapers get together on a weekly basis and have a meeting about, you know, how we're going to blast the Republican Party. No, I don't. I mean. But I do think there's a slant, yeah.
Does that slant make it difficult to control the message that you're trying to put out about your own party in any given particular race?
You know, you have to be cognizant of a person that you're dealing with. You got to be cognizant of the newspaper that you're dealing with. But you know, here in Tennessee, we have a very good relationship with the newspapers. You know, I tell them when I think that they're wrong. You know, and we keep each other in check.
Right. Well, very good. Well, I appreciate your time today. Thanks for being here with us.
All right. Well, thank you.
If you would like more information on the Republican Party in Tennessee, you can log on to their website at tngop.org. And we hope you will join us again next time here on Inside Politics.